Now I will show the cause why the solar receiver can produce high temperature heat. Here we see very cheap primitive mirrors, which focus solar radiation on the receiver. Now I show those mirrors, and we see that it is a cheap reflective polymer film. This is the spot of solar radiation from the mirror in the winter, when the sun is low above the horizon. Of course, the focusing has poor quality, but this is not a big problem if we use a wide receiver, as on my solar station. Obviously, in the spring the sun height increases, and therefore the spot is located in a different place if you refuse to change the vertical angle of the mirrors. Here we can observe how the wind worsens the focusing. In addition, we understand that wind can be a problem for the lifespan of our cheap mirrors, and I will describe the solutions to this problem in a few minutes. So, I made this mirror from this reflective mylar film, which was bought at a price of 20 American cents per square meter from one of the Ukrainian manufacturers. It is about 1,000 times cheaper than these mirrors of modern solar power plants. My idea is to build such long rows of such cheap mirrors. Of course, we need a cheap receiver, which will be located in the focus of our mirrors, and I plan to test two versions of the receiver. This is the first version, and I described it in one of my old videos about a month ago. The second version of the receiver was described by my third YouTube channel, and its link is below. I remind you that my mirror systems do not need to change their position from morning to evening, and I described their capabilities and features in some of my old videos. In addition, I plan to explore the second variant of cheap mirror, which has this additional cheap polymer film. It is obvious that the additional film helps the mirror withstand strong winds. However, let's look at the first variant of my mirror without that additional film. We see that the bottom edge of the mirror is not fixed, and the weight of the structure can make the mirror have a minimum wrinkles. Now we can understand that the mirror can be easily and quickly removed or installed, and this is important if you plan to use our mirrors for several weeks or months per year. For example, for heating a greenhouse only during March, or for space heating of a house from November to February. In other words, we can remove our mirrors at the end of the heating season, and therefore the lifespan of our short-lived mirrors can reach several seasons. We understand that these wires provide our mirrors the desired shape. Now I show that I use different types of the wires to find the difference between them. But we see that any difference is missing. I have to do long-term research, during which I will wait for the mirror to be destroyed by a strong wind to find its weak point. For example, this incident helped me find another weak point here. This is a new mirror, where that weak point is reinforced. It is obvious that winds must destroy some more of my mirrors, so that I can find some more weak points and strengthen them. After finishing the research, my third YouTube channel will describe the final version of this type of cheap mirrors, which will be able to withstand strong winds. Of course, we have the opportunity to temporarily remove the mirrors before hurricane, and I remind you that my second version of the mirror has more ability to withstand strong winds. I predict that the lifespan of my cheap mirrors will be only a few months, and it will be several times less than the lifespan of this more expensive type of mirror, where the same reflective film is fixed to a sheet of expanded polystyrene. That is why I am talking about the ability to quickly replace old mirrors, and about the appropriateness for a short working season, or if we need cheap solar energy for only a few short periods per year. Now I will show one of the causes of the short lifespan of my cheap mirrors, and we must pay attention to such transparent points. This film worked for about 3 weeks, and we can compare it with this new film, which was installed a few hours ago. We know that this reflective film is a thin polymer sheet, and one of its sides is coated with a very thin layer of aluminum, which reflects radiation. These transparent points are places where the aluminum layer is already lost, and it is obvious that the accumulation of these points due to its edging will gradually reduce the efficiency of the mirror. This is another of my research, and the aluminum layer of this mirror is located on the sunny side of the film. In contrast, the aluminum layer of the second option coats its north side. Let's pay attention here where the reflective film touches the virus. We see that the virus destroyed the aluminum layer of these places on the first option of the mirror, while the second option has no similar defect. But the second option has defects of its aluminum layer near the bottom edge of the mirror. Nevertheless, I think that the lifespan of the first option will be longer than the second. Thus, the aluminum layer should coat the south side of the film. However, we must understand that solar radiation will quickly destroy the polymer of the places where the aluminum layer is absent. That is why I am afraid that the mirror will crack in these places in a few months. I plan to report the real longevity of my mirrors after the end of their research. This will be done on my third YouTube channel, and its link is below. Of course, the lifespan of these mirrors will be short due to their fast aging and the probability of a hurricane. However, these are very cheap mirrors, and their replacement is simple and quick. I want to clarify that this inkjet is not adequately show the real heat capacity. Before this, the receiver was without water for 20 minutes, and therefore the sun heated its metal parts to a high temperature, and then I gave it water from this bucket. In addition, we must pay attention to the fact that the receiver is covered with cellular polycarbonate.